Father and Ashab al Ajma'in. Welcome for you all, inshallah, for the first majlis. Actually, this one is the second, but for the reading, the book is the first majlis. So if there is someone, he will, you know, will calculate for us how many majlis, because in the ijazah persona, so I will write here how many majlis and the period, how long time, like that. So if someone, he can write it, write down, inshallah. So this one is the first majlis, and we will start beginning of this book, inshallah. Actually, there is some sentence we will repeat it every majlis. For majlis ijazah bersanad, we will repeat one sentence that is bil asanid sahihah almuttasilah ila al-imam at-tirmidzi. That means by the sanad, the right sanad from me until Imam at-tirmidzi. We will say like that. Okay, this just like the adat, the way of the ulama in the hadith, they will repeat it every majlis. So, inshallah, I will repeat it and you will understand. Bil asanidi sahihati muttasilati ila Imam al-Tirmidhi. Because we need the ijazah bersanad until Imam al-Tirmidhi. And inside the book, Imam al-Tirmidhi, he mentioned every person from him until Rasulullah. Okay, until Rasulullah. Who has the book that all of the names is mentioned? What's the name? Yusuf. Oh, okay. Sheikh Yusuf. Sheikh Yusuf, have it. Anyone else has the book? Haven't, huh? Okay, it's okay, inshallah. So just to me, inshallah, I will just mention the names. Actually, maximum is 5 names or 6 names, but usually become 4 or 5 like that, inshallah. Inshallah, bil asanid sahihah al-muttasilah ila al-imam at-tirmidhi annahu qala babu ma ja'a fi khalq rasulillahi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. معنا صلى الله عليه وسلم قال حدثنا أبو رجاء قتيبة بن سعيد عن مالك بن أنس عن ربيعة بن أبي عبد الرحمن عن أنس بن مالك أنه سمعه يقول كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ليس بالطويل البائن ولا بالقصير ولا بالأبيض الأمهق ولا بالآدم ولا بالجعد القطط ولا بالسبط بعثه الله تعالى على رأس 40 سنة فأقام بمكة 10 سنين وبالمدينة 10 سنين وتوفاه الله على رأس 60 سنة وليس في رأسه ولحيته 20 شعرة بيضاء. So who has the translation? You can read it. In Malay or in English, it's okay. Doesn't matter. Your book in Malay.
In Malay and Arabic.
Okay, watch it.
Watch it.
Yeah, yeah.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Ma ja'a fi khalqi Rasulullah. Chiri physical Rasulullah.
Ah, physical. Okay.
Maksudnya diriwayatkan daripada Anas bin Malik radhiyallahu anhu, dia bercerita kepada Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
Dia bukan tinggi, bukan apa ni, pindah. So Rasulullah, that means he is harmony, like harmonic physical in between. The tall is not very tall, and is not very short. So that means if Rasulullah in between the people that is very tall, Rasulullah is suitable with them. And if Rasulullah with the people who is, you know, short, so become like suitable with him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created him like that. Okay, the second sentence.
Warna kulitnya tidak terlalu putih dan tidak pula terlalu merah.
Also harmony. For example, if Rasulullah in the dark place, you will look at him like he is dark skin. His skin is like dark. But if he is in the light place, he very, very white. Okay. So now, after this, always we will find some the words they say, Rasulullah, he is dark, and another hadith, he is white. That means, depends on the place, according to the place, if the place is dark or light. Okay? So, after that? Yeah, so for his, you know, he say like the Arab people. It's not like the Malay. The Malay is very straight, you know. The high is straight one. But for Rasulullah, is not very, you know what you call it? It's rolled up like the Orang Afrika. It's not like Orang Afrika and is not like Orang Malay. He is like the people, the Arab people, he have the wings, like wings. Like the wing. Okay?
Okay? Allah Ta'ala memutuskan baginda menjadi Nabi ketika usianya mula mencecah 40 tahun.
This umur, Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala never mentioned any umur in the Quran except this umur. Hatta idha balaga ashuddahu wa balaga 40 sana in Surah Al-Ahqaf. So this umur is very important for the people, for the person. Why? Because his akal, his brain will be matured and is completed in this umur. Okay? Before that, he still needs some ilmu, he still needs some thinking. But when he reached 40 years, his akal will be matured and completed. Okay? And every Nabi, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never sent him before 40. And many people, they have mistake when they say that Nabi is Nabi Isa, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent him when his umr is 33. That one is wrong, actually. Because, of course, this one is, is confirmed that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send every Nabi after 40 years. That means after his akal is completed. Okay? So, Nabi Isa, after 40 years, Allah sent him and he was in the life for 33 years. That means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take him up to the sky. His umr is? His umr was 73. Yeah. Okay, after that.
Baginda tinggal di Mekah selepas dilantik jadi Nabi selama 10 tahun dan di Madinah juga 10 tahun.
Actually, it's not 10 tahun in Mekah. Actually, it's 13 years. It's 13 years. Okay, why? Why in the hadith it mentioned 10 only?
Open da'wah.
Open the da'wah, okay. Another answer? You have any idea? Because in the Sejarah, if we look at the book in Sejarah, they will tell us Rasulullah he stayed in Mecca for 13 days, 1-3. Yeah? So yes. Why in the hadith is 10 only? Because the Arabs they never care what in between 10 and 15. 15 and 20, they didn't calculate 8. So they don't like to say 17 or 16 or like that. So they will complete it until 20 or they will till 15. So that means 10, 15, 20, 25, 13 and like that. Okay. So now he mentioned the lower one, that is 10, but actually it's 13. But they don't like to say thalatha ashara, become two words actually. Thalatha ashara. Okay, so two words. He want to mention one word. Wafahu Allah.
Setelah itu baginda diwafatkan Allah Ta'ala ketika awal usia 60 tahun.
Actually, 63. 63. But also they didn't kira. Okay. They didn't account.
Kepala dan janggutnya tidak sampai 20 helai, rambut berwarna putih.
My friend, he is from Ahlul Bayt. And I, you know, I, what do you call it? I percaya he is from Ahlul Bayt because he has the sifat, inshallah. Later, I will tell you how you will know some person he is from Ahlul Bayt. There is two types, the physical sifat and the, what do you call it? Intangible sifat. Okay? Intangible sifat. So, both of it I found out from him. So, he told me, I saw Rasulullah in my dream and I look at his hair. And that time I can, I can account how many, you know, white hair. And he said it's 13 hair. He said like that. But Allah wa'alam, in the hadith is 20. He said 20. He's not more than 20. And this 20 white, what do you call it? White hair, right?
Gray.
Okay, this one, if we will know where is in his face or in his head, actually in three places. I don't know in English, but I will show you. This one, the first one, second and third. And these three places. So whole of his hair in the up haven't, except in this place. Okay, and actually I have, you know, there is no hair here, but also my hair, you know. So, and this one, the first one, what do you call it, this one?
Cyber.
And this one, what do you call it?
Guti.
And this one in the middle, okay? These three places. 1, 2, 3. Or you can say 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. In these three places only. But the whole of his body, like in his chest, the hair on the chest or in the hand, he never have it. Just three places. Okay. Okay, any question about this hadith? You have any question? Okay, I have one comment about the Rijalul Isnad. Rijalul Isnad, that means every person, the person of the hadith, okay, who carry the hadith. There is two person. The first one, he is Malik ibn Anas. This is Imam Malik, and he is Sheikh of Imam Shafi'i. And his Sheikh is Rabi'a ibn Abi Abd al-Rahman, or we call it Rabi'a ibn Farrukh. There is some story about Rabi'a ibn Abd al-Rahman, ibn Abi Abd al-Rahman, the Sheikh of Imam Malik. Sheikh of Imam Malik, his father, he left him, he's not left him, left his mother, okay, left his mother when he was inside, or in, what do you call, in Rahim, and he's Hamil with him. He left her and he went to Jihad fi Sabilillah for 27 years. And that time when he left her, he gave her some money. He gave her around 30,000 dinar. Dinar, this one is gold. 30,000. And he said, okay, this one is your nafkah. Okay, I will go to Jihad fi Sabilillah for a few years and I will come back. So this few years becomes 27. 27 years. And that time he never knew that is his wife is Hamil already. So he went Jihad Visabilla and he left her. So she became Hamil and she Berana. After that, she Mendidi Yana Yangachil. Somebody Yajadi Besara. Umur dia berapa? Dekat 30. Dan dia jadi daripada ulama'ul Madinah. Ulama Medina, and he is Sheikh of Imam Shafi'i, Sheikh of Imam Malik, and Imam Malik, he is Sheikh Imam Shafi'i. That means Sheikh of our Imam, Sheikh of our Imam. Okay. So there is some story. Some of the ulama, they say this one is not true. They are doubting of it, and some of the ulama, they will agree. They say this story is betul. Okay, so when his father is coming back to Medina, because he become orang tua, so he coming back to the Medina after 27 years, he knows where is his house in the Medina. That time is before Maghrib, and he straight go to his house. When he knock on the door, his wife is going out. His wife, her name is Suhaila. So he asked her, you are Farrukh. His name is Farrukh, Abu Abd al-Rahman. You are Farrukh, okay, welcome, enter, and he enter inside. And after he sit down and give him some to eat. After that, he asked him, where is 30,000 dinar? Where is 30,000 dinar that he left it with her? Oh, that time, he said, actually, okay, eat first. And after this, you can go to the Masjid al-Nabawi, pray dulu, pray Maghrib and Isha, and after that, coming back after Isha. Just go to the Masjid al-Nabawi. Okay. He ate and he drank. She said, okay, after Isha, I will tell you where is the money. He thought she hide the money in somewhere. She will look at it and take it back. So he went to the Maghrib, and they prayed the Maghrib, and stay in the Masjid until the Isha. In between Maghrib and Isha, and he saw there is some halaqa in the Masjid. Very big, this halaqa. It's very big. He cannot see the Sheikh who is teach. It's very big. So after that, after finished the Isha, he coming back home. That time when he entered, he asked again, where is my money? Where is the 30,000? She said, what did you see in the masjid, Nabawi? He said, there is some halakha is very big until I cannot see the sheikh. And she said, okay, what's about that sheikh? What if this sheikh is your son? And he said, oh, that is my son. She said, yeah, and all of the money I spent it for him. So now you want 30,000 or you want that son? He said, no, I want that son. So after that, he become like the crazy. He go out to the Medina and he say, Rabi Atara is my son, Rabi Atara is my son. And he become very, very glad, very happy. So now, what I remember from this kissa, I remember that the mother is very, very important, actually. Because if we look at Imam Shafi'i, who educated him, his mother. And for Imam Malik, his mother also. Actually, Imam Malik, Sheikh of Imam Shafi'i, the first time, he was a singer, you know? In the beginning, when he was Orang Muda, he was a singer, he liked to sing, actually. So in the first time, so his mother told him, okay, my son, the people they didn't like, they like to hurt, but if his face is ugly, they didn't like it. They didn't like him. Because he was very ugly, Imam Malik. So after that, he left the sing and become from the ulama and he sing the ilmu. Okay? So the mother is very important. If we came to the ayah in Surah Ali Imran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will firman, وَلَيْسَ الذَّكَرُ كَالْأُنْثَى وَلَيْسَ الذَّكَرُ كَالْأُنْثَى. What means الذَّكَرُ لَيْسَ
الذَّكَرُ كَالْأُنْثَى? It's not the same with men and women.
Okay, the arrangement is very important. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَيْسَ بُكَنْ الذَّكَرُ وَلَنْ يَلَكِ كَا مَشَامْ الْأُنْثَى وَلَنْ بُرْبُوَنْ. Okay, أَنَا بُرْبُوَنْ. So in Arabic, if you want to do some analogy, who is become first, that is mushabbah. The person who want, what we want to give him the sifat from another person. Okay? Like I will say, you are very strong like the lion. Who is stronger? The lion. So the second one, he is bigger than or better than the first one. This one in the Arabic, the Arabic grammar. So now, that means al-dakar is lower. So al-dakar is lower than al-untha. Is al-dakar is lower than al-untha because al-untha is more what do you call it? Is bitter than al-dakar. So how we can answer? Is bitter or no?
Better.
Okay, I will not. If it's bitter, if you say it's bitter, so give me the dalil. I have the dalil. I will say al-dakar is bitter. Why? Ana lelaki bitter. Why? Because every Nabi, he is lelaki. Okay, and the president cannot be woman. Should be lelaki. This one is my dalil. What is your dalil?
The Prophet said,
Allahu Akbar. Of course he was.
Respect mother by the mother.
Okay, respect. What's more?
I don't know.
Hajar
has
a house next to the Baitullah.
Okay, Hajar. And all of us, we follow her, even though we are unlocated. What else?
The leader of the heavens, Amin.
Allahu Akbar. The leader, okay. What else?
And we carry you, man.
Okay, the man. Actually, we cannot, like we cut the ayat or cut the sentence from the ayat and we make the tafsir. We have to follow the context. The context of the surah is about Ali Imran. And Ali Imran, they are very, very good people. And some of them, there is Maryam. And Maryam, this one, Ana Yang Saleh. So now we can say, وَلَيْسَ الذَّكَرُ كَالْأُنْثَ الصَّالِحَ. Is nothing better than this Imam Ibn Kathir. You know the Tafsir Ibn Kathir? Imam Ibn Kathir, he said in his book, in this ayat, in the Tafsir, he said, is nothing in the dunya, nothing, no, is not the person. He said, nothing in the dunya better than al-untha saliha. Why? Because if we got untha saliha, that means her sons or her children is salih. Her society become salih. And for his husband, her husband will become Salih also. But if we have just the lilaki, Salih, that is Salih for himself only. It's not for the society or for the children or no anymore. That is the woman, al-unha saliha, her benefits, the benefit from her is more than a dhaka. But we with one condition, that is a saliha. If she is not saliha, the society become rosa, her family, and all of them. Okay? So the ulama, they say, one woman that is rude woman, she will destroy what 100 ulama have built it. She can, just one woman, she can destroy what 100 imam they have built it before. She can. Okay, the second hadith. Okay, I will read it in Arabic. قال حدثنا حميد بن مسعدة البصري قال حدثنا عبد الوهاب الثقفي عن حميد عن أنس بن مالك قال كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ربعة ليس بالطويل ولا بالقصير حسن الجسم وكان شعره ليس بجعد ولا سبط أسمر اللون إذا مشى يتكفى.
Diriwayatkan daripada Anas bin Malik radhiyallahu anhu, Rasulullah SAW merupakan seorang yang berketinggian sederhana, iaitu tidak terlalu tinggi dan tidak pula rendah.
Same.
Physical baginda adalah cantik.
Okay, he is beautiful. Actually, his body is a harmonic body. That means he is in very tall and thin, and is very fat and is short. No, he is suitable with in between the tallness and the thinness. Okay, this two is like harmony. Okay,
proportion.
We can say perfect. Okay, after that. And his hair.
Rambut baginda tidak kerinting dan tidak pula terlalu lurus.
Okay, sama juga.
Kulit sedikit kemerahan dan apabila berjalan baginda berjalan.
That one in the dark place. So he explained about Rasulullah in the dark place. When he saw him in the dark place, he saw him like the dark skin. Okay. Ida. Okay. After.
Apabila baginda berjalan, condong ke depan.
Maknanya dada dia ke depan. Okay. So if he want to walk, he will not walk like this. You know, he will make his his chest ahead, and he will walk like that. Okay. After that, he will explain about this sentence. He will explain in the next hadith, or after two hadiths. Okay, any question about this hadith? Any question?
Ustaz, in my translation, it said he had a wheat-colored complexion. That means perumpamaan macam kulit dia macam warna gandum.
Oh, that means
wheat-colored complexion.
Yeah. Another, also, there is another hadith. He said mixed in between white and red. Oh, okay. Actually, many. Okay? But we can say Rasulullah, he is not very white and is not, he is dark. He is dark and what do you call it? Is near to the white. It's like that.
Allah.
Allah. Okay. The next hadith. Okay, another question? Another question?
Maybe you can tell us why
he used the word Asmar rather than Ahmar. Bye, mashallah. Actually, there is some hadith. Okay, in Arabic, we have two words. One word is Asmar and another word is Ahmar. The Ahmar, this one is red, and the Asmar is dark. Okay, dark.
Yeah.
Okay, so now, about the people who is Hitam, orang Hitam, you cannot call him Ya Aswad. You cannot call him Ya Aswad, orang Hitam. Never do it. The Sahaba, they will call him Ya Ahmar or Ya Asmar. Okay? This one like more respect. Inshallah, in one hadith, in Syamail Muhammadiyah, Rasulullah, it's not Rasulullah, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. Sahabat, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, he called someone, he is Ahmar. Ahmar, that is, is beautiful or more kindness. Okay, Jazakallah. Another question?
Asmar
dark. And Ahmar is red. Yeah. Okay, any question?
This discussion is about the color red.
He give more explanation.
Red. It's not mention of the dark color, but it's not red color.
But actually, the exactly translation asma, that means dark.
Dark.
Dark chocolate. Dark.
Brown.
Okay, maybe or brown.
Yeah.
And then he said, حَدَّثَنَا مُحَمَّدْ بْنُ بَشَّارِ. Okay, in this hadith, okay, before I pass to the next hadith, who is the rawi, who is the narrator the hadith?
Anas.
Just now?
Anas.
Anas ibn Malik. Sayyiduna Anas ibn Malik, he's from the Sahabat. And the first time, you know, who brought him to Rasulullah?
His mother.
And his mother is very, very smart. She brought him to Rasulullah. She said, Ya Rasulullah, this one is your humble. How, there is any mother will give her son like humble to another person? No one. The first one. The second one, one day she said, Ya Rasulullah, this one is your humble. Can you make dua for him? And Rasulullah, he said, okay. Allahumma barik lahu. Allah, and Rasulullah bagi dua to him, the barakah. So he said, his umur is 120, the first one. The second one, he never got white hair. White hair is never got it. And he has 70 sons. 70, 70, okay, sons. And about his, what do you call it? His money, his
wealth.
About his wealth, he don't know it. He said, I don't know what is it. Because he's a lot and many. You know? Because of yani barakah, dua, the barakah from Rasulullah. Because of his mother. And also, if I want to explain for you, there is... His mother, her name is Umm Sulaim. Okay. Sulaim. This one is mother of Imam Malik. Actually, she. Allah. You are a lecturer, right?
We don't plan to teach.
Okay, I will continue. Makra,
Adel. We plan to be taught.
Okay, she has it. Small
one. Ah, mashallah. But say.
Such a small one.
Okay, I will suggest you buy this one. You know, this one is refill. You know,
yeah.
Can make refill. Okay, this one Umm Sulaim. Actually, she got married with two person. The first one, his name is Malik bin Al-Nadr. And the second one with Abu Talha. T-H or T-A?
Al-Ha.
Actually, this one is Ta. Ta. She got from Malik Anas Sahaja. Yaitu Anas ibn Malik, the Sahaba, Hamba Rasulullah. And before Islam, he got angry at her because she entered the Islam and he left the Medina and no one knows he went to where. Okay? Mm. One. And for after the Islam, Rasulullah came to the Medina, and she has just one son. So this one that is Anas, and she give him to Rasulullah. Okay. After that, for Abu Talha, she got three sons. One his name is Ishaq. Another one is Abdullah. And the third one is Abu Umayyah. You know Abu Umair, that Rasulullah, he said, Ya Abu Umair, ma fa'ala Nughair? There is this Abu Umair, he is son, brother of, or step brother of Sayyiduna Anas. He was playing with some bird, his name is Al-Nughair. And Rasulullah, he want to, you know, and this bird has passed away, Al-Mati. And Rasulullah, he want to, you know, inshallah, this hadith will come in Shama'il. And Rasulullah, he want to make some joke with him, and he said, okay, where is the Al-Nughair, Ya Aba Umair, and he make like Saja, you know, Ya Aba Umair, ma fa'al Al-Nughair, like that. Mm-hmm. So this one, when Rasulullah, he make joke with him, this one is Abu Umair. Mm-hmm. Okay? So this one, about the Anas ibn Malik. So that time, he can focus with Rasulullah. His father will not ask him anything, no order from him, and his mother also didn't ask him. So he will focus with Rasulullah. And who is Imam Anas, Sayyiduna Anas ibn Malik, he is one of the seven Sahabat who what do you call it? Bani Hadith. No, Bani Hadith from Rasulullah. Narrated Hadith, many Hadith from Rasulullah. One of the Sahabat. Okay? There is Aisha, Sayyidatuna Aisha, Abdullah ibn Umar, Abdullah ibn Abbas, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, and this Anas ibn Malik, and another two. Jabir ibn Abdullah al-Ansari, and there is another one. Okay, so they are seven. He is one of the seven. Okay, one of the
seven.
Abu Huraira. Abu Huraira. Okay, قال حدثنا محمد البشار قال حدثنا محمد الجعفر قال حدثنا شعبة عن أبي إسحاق قال سمعت البراء بن عازب يقول كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم رجلا مربوعا بعيد ما بين المنكبين عظيم الجمة إلى شحمة أذنيه عليه حلة حمراء ما رأيت شيئا قط أحسن منه.
Diriwayatkan daripada Al-Bara' bin Azib, beliau menceritakan Rasulullah SAW merupakan seorang yang berketinggian sederhana. Antara dua bahu baginda adalah jauh atau lebar.
That means his chest is very wide, very big. Yeah.
Rambut cuma hanya tebal dari atas kepala hingga ke bawah.
Okay, about his about the hair of Rasulullah. Actually, in the hadith there is three words or three situations repeated. So, if one time in the hadith like here they say what is it?
Al-Jumma.
And there is another hadith, there is Limma. Another hadith is Wafra. So now I will explain for you, so you will not confuse in between these three. Okay, in Arabic. We can gather the three situations of Rasulullah has, that is walajja. Okay, walajja, that means enter. Okay, but this one just want to remember. Okay, like keyword. This one, the first one is waw. Waw daripada wafra. Waw. And lam is limma. And the third one is Jumma. Okay, Wafra, Limma, Jumma. Okay, this three, yeah? And you have to arrange it like this. You cannot say Jalaw or Lajaw or like that. You have to follow this arrangement. Why? Because this one is the first one is the shorter one. Okay? And this one is the second and this one is the third. What is the difference? If his hair
is short,
the shorter one is Wafra. And after that is longer than Wafra is Limma, and then the last one is Jumma. Okay, what is the difference in between these three? The first one, Wafra, that is tall but cannot reach his neck. Okay, like he's become tebal here. Okay, like he's big here but cannot go down. He didn't go down. This one is Wafra. The second one is Limma. That is go down, but they didn't reach the shoulder. Go down is longer than Wafra. Okay, so this one is tebal. This one is more than tebal. Okay, and lagi panjang. Okay, the third one is Jumma, that is very tall until reach his shoulder. Okay, these three situations. So now, one day we look at Rasulullah. Actually, his hair is Wafra, and he said it's Wafra. He told the Sahaba or told Tabi'in what he saw it from Rasulullah. Maybe after 1 year or after 6 months, another Sahaba, he looked at Rasulullah and he saw his hair is longer. Okay, lagi panjang. And maybe after 1 year, 2 years, and it become very tall. Like in Fathu Makkah, when Rasulullah he want to open Makkah, that time his hair is too long until he, you know, kumbul it. He gather it in six. What do you call it? Six likat. Likat. Ikat. 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 Okay? Like that. Inshallah, after that. Yeah.
We can do it.
So,
okay,
any question? Any question? Nanti akan bagi tahu insyaallah. Al-Bara' bin Azib. About Al-Bara' bin Azib. If you ask about Al-Bara' bin Azib. Al-Bara' bin Azib. So it is your son.
No, sorry.
Okay, Al-Bara' bin Azib is from the Sahabat, and who is opening the door for the Sahabat to enter Hadikatul Maut. Hadikatul Maut, one place that is Musaylamat al-Kadhab. You know Musaylamat al-Kadhab, who said, I'm the Nabi after Rasulullah. He was in one kubu, there is some kubu, and all of it is wall. The Sahabat cannot enter, casually from the door. And this door is very tall and very strong. When they want to, you know, to break it, they cannot break it. So the Sahabat, they, you know, they carry him and up of the door, and he dropped down from another side. When he dropped down, all of them, they are waiting by the soldier, they are waiting by the, you know, what do you call it? This one?
Yes. Tomba.
Yeah, so when he goes down, everyone, he, you know, killed him. But he can carry until he can open the door. So he handled it until book opened the door and all the Sahaba is in there. So after that, no one knows him after that. No one knows him. Because when the door opened, all of them, they, you know, they walk on him. They step on him and they enter inside. Of course, from long time, you know. So in the first time, they, you know, they kill him or... It's not kill him, they, you know,
slash.
Yeah, they slash him many times, and he can handle until open the door. When he opened the door, the Sahabat or the Kufar, they step on him. So no one knows where he is. Like become daging, you know? Allah.
Sorry, what was the name again?
Al-Bara' ibn Azib, who is the narrator of the hadith? Narrator of the hadith.
Okay.
Another one from the Rijal al-Isnad, his name is Muhammad ibn Bashar. Actually, the first name in the Isnad, okay, in the first name, his name is Muhammad ibn Bashar. This person, he is sheikh for all of the Imam of six books. That Imam al-Bukhari, he takes the hadith from him. Imam Muslim also. All of them, they take from Muhammad ibn Bashar.
So his name is Bundar?
Bundar.
Bundar.
Yeah, Muhammad ibn Bashar. This one is the real name of him, but there is some laqab. What do you call it? Laqab?
Nickname.
They call him Bundar. Yeah. Actually, Muhammad ibn Bashar, Muhammad ibn Muthanna, Muhammad ibn al-Ala, Nasr ibn Ali al-Jahdami, Yaqub al-Dawraqi, Abdullah ibn Sa'id al-Ashaj. This one is 6. The total is 10. I just remember 6. Okay, Nandi, if we got another one, I will tell you. Who is the sheikh for 6 imams? Okay. Another question? Shahma, this one is the lip, the lip, we call it?
Look.
This one is for the wafra, okay? For the wafra. Or this one is Jumma.
Oh, bro, that bro.
Okay, the last sentence. Yeah, the last sentence.
Baginda memakai pakaian gulah berwarna merah.
That is soit, you know? The shirt with trouser. We call it hulla. We call it hulla. So Rasulullah, he actually wear it. It's not Rasulullah always, he, you know, he wear the, what do you call it, the thaw. It's not always. Sometimes Rasulullah, he will wear the t-shirt with the trouser. But actually, the t-shirt is longer, like, it's not like this t-shirt, it's long, actually.
Kurta.
Like the
Kurta.
Pakistani.
Kurta.
Yeah. Rasulullah wear this. Yeah. This one is hulla. We call it hulla. But here they say hullatun hamra. Okay? Merah. Actually, for this one, we have khilaf in between the ulama. Some of the ulama, they say, you cannot wear the red color. You cannot. Okay? And some of the ulama, they say, can. You can wear it. So, how we can manage in between these two opinions. We can say the full color, the full red color, and is all of it is red color, is completed red color. There is no another, you know, another color with it. Like if I wear the red color and there is some lines, white line, okay, can, no problem.
Oh.
But if all of it, from the up until the down, all of it is red, are you gonna do it?
Solid red.
Why, what?
For men. For men?
They, in that time, for what, actually? For what? So we have to add another color with the red color, actually. Okay.
Color block.
Yeah, the red color, they say...
Is it haram or makruh?
It's not haram, actually, but this one will...
Makruh.
Shukra. That will bring to you the famous, become like famous.
Oh! Attraction.
Yeah, you have to go to be with the all, like same, you know? So the red color is very...
Striking. Striking.
Yeah, like this one is the sebab, Allah.
له شعر يضرب منكبيه بعيد ما بين المنكبين لم يكن بالقصير ولا بالطويل.
I think all of it that is we have it before. Okay, so I can pass to the next.
Yes.
Yeah, but misty there is another color.
Only for a prophet.
No, the Rasulullah he wore it but with another color. Actually, the hadith, I think in Sahih Bukhari, Muslim, Rasulullah, he was praying the Salah, and he looked at his cloth during the Salah, inside the Salah.
Oh,
and after finish, he take it off and give it to another person. And he said, this one is like kachau. He said, he looked like more. The hadith in Sahih Bukhari, Muslim. قال ثم نيكست حديث قال حدثنا محمد بن اسماعيل قال حدثنا ابو نعيم قال حدثنا المسعودي عن عثمان بن مسلم بن هرمز عن نافع بن جبير بن مطعم عن علي بن ابي طالب قال لم يكن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم بالطويل ولا بالقصير شثل الكفين والقدمين ضخم الراس ضخم الكراديس طويل المسربه اذا مشى تكفأ تكفؤا كانما ينحط من صبب لم ارى قبله ولا بعده مثله صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Diriwayatkan daripada Ali bin Abi Talib radhiyallahu anhu, dia menceritakan Nabi Muhammad SAW tidak tinggi dan tidak pula rendah.
Okay, sama.
Dua tapak tangan dan tapak kaki agak kasar dan tebal.
So his head, his hand is very big, you know. Is big like shathnu. Shathnu, this one is like thick. Okay. And then. Dakhmur ra'sa bani.
Kepala dia. Ukuran kepala baginya dan begitu juga seni-seni tulangnya adalah besar.
Besar. Sebab tadi dia kata jadi chest besar. Dia besar. Betul? So maknanya kepala dia suitable dengan chest. So mesti jadi besar.
Bulu halus di dadanya memanjang. Ini baginya mempunyai barisan bulu-bulu halus yang panjang dari dada ke pusat.
Yang satu line of hair daripada dada sampai pusat. Yang ni itu al-masruba Rasulullah habib. Rasulullah habib like one line. Okay, ila kalau
bila berjalan bagi condong ke depan seolah turun ke tempat yang curam.
Ni bagi contoh. Macam dia turun daripada bukit.
Okay. Aku tidak pernah melihat sebelum dan selepasnya orang seperti sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
Okay, untuk next hadis and after it is hadis daif. Three hadis. The next hadith, and after it, and after. Number 6, 7, 8. So I will read it in Arabic. It's too long, no? قال حدثنا سفيان بن وكيع قال حدثنا أبي عن المسعود وذكر بهذا الإسناد نحوه بمعناه.
قال حدثنا أبو عبدة الضبي البصري وعلي بن حجر وأبو جعفر محمد بن الحسين وابن أبي حليمة والمعنى واحد. قال وحدثنا عيسى بن يونس عن عمر بن عبد الله مولى غفرة قال حدثني أبي قال حدثني إبراهيم بن محمد بن ولد علي بن أبي طالب قال كان علي إذا وصف رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال لم يكن بالطويل الممغط ولا بالقصير المتردد وكان ربعة من القوي لم يكن بالجعد القطط ولا بصدق كان جعد الرجلة ولم يكن بالمطهم ولا بالمكلثم وكان في وجهه تدبير أبيض المشرب أدعج العينين أهدب الأشفار جليل المشاش والكتد أجرد ذو مسربة شثن الكفين والقدمين إذا مشى تقلع كأنما ينحط من صدر وإذا التفت التفت معه بين كتفيه خاتم النبوة وخاتم النبيين أجود الناس صدرا وأصدق الناس لاجة ولأنهم عريكة وأكرمهم عشرة أو قال عشرة من رآه بديهة هابه ومن خلطه معرفة أحبه ويقول نعيد لما رأى قبله ولا بعده مثله صلى الله عليه وسلم. قال أبو عيسى until here the hadith is finished already but is hadith ضعيف is weak hadith so we will not accept in our head. Okay. قال أبو عيسى أبو عيسى this one is إمام الترمذي he was accepting the hadith. Okay. قال أبو عيسى سمعت أبا جعفر محمد بن حسين يقول سمعت الأصمعي يقول في تفسير صفة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم الممغط الذائب طولا وقال سمعت عربيا يقول في كلامه تمغط في نشابته أي مدها مدا شديدا والمتردد داخل بعضه في بعضه قصرا وأما القطط فشديد الجعودة والرجل الذي في شعره حجون أي تثني قليل وأما المطهم فالبادل الكثير اللحم والمكلثم المذور الوجه والمشرب الذي في بياض حمرة والأدعج الشديد سواد العين والأهدب طويل الأشفار والكدد مجتمع الكتفين وهو الكاهل والمسربة والشعر الدقيق الذي كأنه قضيب من الصدر من الصدر إلى السرة والشثن الغليظ الأصابع من الكفين والقدمين والتقلع أن يمشي بقوة والصبب الحدور نقول انحدرنا من صبوب وصبب وقوله جليل المشاشي يريد رؤوس المناكب والعشرة الصعبة والعشير الصعب والبديهة المفاجأة يقال بدهته بأمن أي فجأته. This one is the hadith number 6, 7 have finished and now is the number 8. قال حدثنا سفيان المكي قال حدثنا جميع بن عمر بن عبد الرحمن العجلي إبلاء علينا من كتابه قال أخبرني رجل من بني تميم ولد أبي هالة زوجي خديجة يكنى أبا عبد الله عن ابن لأبي هالة عن الحسن بن علي قال سألته خالي هند بن أبي هالة وكان وصافا عن حلية النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وأنا أشتهي أن يصف لي من شيء أتعلق به فقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فخما مفخما يتلألأ وجهه تلألؤ القمر ليلة البدر أطول من البربوع وأقصر من المشذب عظيم الهامة رجل الشعر إن انفرقت عقده فرقه وإلا فلا يجاوز شعره شحمة أذنيه إذا هو وفره أزر اللون واسع الجبين أزج الحواجب سوابغ في غير قرن بينهما عرق يدر الغضب أقنى العرنين له نور يعلوه يحسبه من لم يتأمله أشمه كث اللحية سهل الخدين ضليع الفم مفلج الأسنان دقيق المسربة كأن عنق وجيد دمية في صواه فضة معتدل الخلق بادل متماسك سواء البطن والصدر عريض الصدر بعيد ما بين المنكبين ضخم الكراديس أنور متجرد موصول ما بين اللبة والسرة بشعر يجري كالخط عالي الثدين والبطن مما سوى ذلك أشعر الذراعين والمنكبين وعالي الصدر طويل الزندين رحب الكفة شذن الكفين والقدمين سائل الأطراف أو قال شائل الأطراف خمصان الأخمصين مسيح القدمين ينبو عنهما الماء إذا زال زال تقلع إذا زال زال قلع يخطو تكفي ويمشي هونا ذريع المشية إذا مشى كأنما ينحط من صبا وإذا التفت التفت جميعا خافض الطرف نظره إلى الأرض أطول من نظره إلى السماء جل نظره الملاحظة يسوق أصحابه ويبدر من لقي بالسلام. You can realize it actually. Usually, Rasulullah, if he want to say, or the Sahaba, if they want to tell anything, they will give the short one. It's very short. And this one is very tall. Some of it is right, some of it is wrong. Actually, one of the sentence that he said, the hair of this one, what do you call it?
Eyebrow.
Like this one. He is chucho Nabi Sayyiduna Ali ibn Abi Talib. But this chucho, he didn't live in the time of Nabi if Sayyiduna Ali ibn Abi Talib. There is some gap, you know, in between Sayyiduna Ali and this
Ibrahim.
Okay, and Ibrahim ibn Muhammad.
Muhammad
Al Hanafiya. Muhammad al Hanafiya ibn Ali. Okay. So this hadith is hadith da'if. Okay.
Okay,
next number
number seven. This one is gap. Some gap in between Ibrahim and Muhammad and Ali ibn Abi Talib. The grandson and the tutor. Okay. And for number eight, the sabab is Sufyan ibn Waqi'. Actually, Waqi', he is Waqi' ibn al-Jarrah, Sheikh of Imam al-Shafi'i. And he is a good person. But his son is good, but the problem with the person who write for him. Usually when he write the hadith, he will add or will delete from the hadith. Okay? So because of his writer, so become his hadith is weak. Because of Sufyan ibn Waqi', the first person in the Sunan. Okay, the next hadith, and I don't know if the last hadith or not. Okay. قال حدثنا أبو موسى محمد بن المثنى قال حدثنا محمد جعبة قال حدثنا شعبة عن سماك بن حرم قال سمعت جابر بن سمرة يقول كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ضليع الفم أشكل العين منهوس العقل قال شعبة قلت لسماك ما ضليع الفم قال عظيم الفم قلت ما أشكل العين قال طويل شق العين قلت ما منهوس العقل قال قليل لحم العقل. أوكي عزب
لرواية كتب جابر بن سمرة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم سؤال يقول قرن مولودنا لبعض
besar, mulut dia besar.
Mata putihnya.
Of course, because when just now he said his head is big, that means his mouth is big also.
Mata putihnya ada warna kemerahan dan tumitnya kecil.
Ya, ashkar al ain. The mata, okay, mata Rasulullah is very white. The white color is very white. Okay. And for the what do you call it in the middle, in the center, is very black. So this one, if this one is very very white and very black, become like shining,
shining black.
Shining black. Okay. This one. But there is another hadith. He said the white color with some of the red color, always having it. Okay. The third second.
Who's
al-aqib?
What is it? Heels. Small heels.
Oh, the heels, the after the foot. Huh? This one is not big. It's not. There is not a lot of dugging. It's like thin, Okay, kitchen. Okay. Qala shurba. Actually, he asked his sheikh about the explanation of these three sifat, and he explained for him. Okay, any question about this hadith?
Ustaz, how come the knee is very small when we have a very big
in the back, just in the back? But his what do you call it? His feet is big, actually, but in the back is thin.
Small.
Yeah, like small.
Small tummy.
What do you call it? Actually, the lahm is dugging, the meat. Mm-hmm. The meat in the bag is not...
It's kind of bony.
His feet is like that. But for this one, who is going up? Okay, who is this one?
The tulang. Yes.
It's not so bad. What do you call it?
Tropically pump.
Yeah.
Okay. When you free, you can see.
Yeah, in the back.
Boat at
from the back.
Think of ping.
Okay, another question.
Ping or tender.
Okay, we have another 5 minutes, huh? Sabar, huh? You know, in I was in Indonesia after Eid al-Fitr. Head of the Malaysia, you know. I was there and for reading Sahih. Imam Muslim, around 7,300 hadiths. Alhamdulillah, we finished it in 7 days.
1,000 a day. 7,300.
In 7 days. That means every day 1,000.
What key?
And there is, after subuh, we'll stand with the sheikh and start reading. And there is 5 readers. And what? I'm one of them. I can read 100 hadiths in one hour. So the sheikh will give me like half hour, and another one, half hour, and the reading will never stop. You can see it in the YouTube. Okay, you can just read, you can write Wadi Mubarak Center. what the Mubarak said, the reading is very fast, you know, very fast, until you say, oh, there is no any benefit from the reading. Actually, time after time, you will get the benefit, because your head will become more suitable with the reading.
Speeding can be fast, is that?
Speeding.
Speeding, yeah.
ثم قال حدثنا حماد بن سليق قال حدثنا عبدر بن قاسم عن أشعث يعني ابن سوار عن أبي إسحاق عن جابر بن سمرة قال رأيت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم في ليلة إضحيان وعليه حلة حمراء فجعلت أنظر إليه وإلى القمر فلهو عندي أحسن من القمر. كعزب.
رواية كان جابر بن سمرة الله أعلم. يوم الشهيد كان. أكبرنا ملهى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. هذا ستو ملام ترام بجرام. ولا بسنا ده تلا أدا أول.
ستو ملام يان.
Terang.
Apa ni terang
terang? Terang. Terang. Terang.
Terang. Terang.
Full moon.
Okay, that means 13, 14, and 15. For Hijra.
Oh.
Yawmul Abid.
Yawmul Abid.
Abiyat.
Abiyat.
No, this is sahih. Actually, for Sheikh Maher Fahri, he said da'ayu. But Sheikh Al-Albani said sahih.
Al-Albani?
Okay.
Yeah. Itu di badan baginda terdapat.
You know why Sheikh Al-Albani he said this one is weak because of hulat al-hamra. Ah. Namanya sih
because
Ash'ad
bin
Sawar. Okay. And he looked at the moon and looked at the Rasulullah. He said, Rasulullah is more beautiful than. Of course. Okay, 3 minutes.